Don't forget to leave a like and subscribe to the Fellowship of Joy YouTube channel. To go up there, fellowshipofjoy.ca.
Welcome back. I'm Pastor Doug. This is our host, Rowan. Tonight, we are reading from the book of Obadiah. So we can either do the overview now or we can discuss it after. What do you think?
Overview? What's
it
on? Talk about what the book is about now.
Really?
Yeah.
Okay, so what's the book about then, host? So the book of Obadiah is a vision from Obadiah. It is very short. It is actually the shortest book in the Old Testament. It's 21 verses long. And it starts out with a prophecy against Edom. We'll talk about who Edom is after we read it, and then it ends with hope for the world. So, let's get into it.
I have some information about why it was written.
Why is that?
According to my Bible, it says, people of the nation of Edom are happy when Jerusalem is destroyed. They take things from the empty city. Obadiah tells them that God is not happy with them. He tells them God will punish them. God will punish the enemies of his people.
Right on. So we'll talk about that after we read it. But let's get into it, okay?
Mm-hmm.
So this is the vision of Obadiah. This is what the Sovereign Lord says about Edom. We have heard a message from the Lord. An envoy was sent to the nations to say, rise, let us go against her for battle. See, I will make you small among the nations, and you will be utterly despised. The pride of your heart has deceived you, you who live in the clefts of the rocks, and make your home on the heights, and you say to yourself, who can bring me down to the ground? Though you soar like the eagle, and make your nest among the stars, from there I will bring you down, declares the Lord. If thieves came to you, if robbers in the night, oh, what a disaster awaits you. Would they not steal only as much as they wanted? If grape pickers came to you, would they not leave a few grapes? But how Esau will be ransacked, his hidden treasures pillaged. All your allies will force you to the border. Your friends will deceive you and overpower you. Those who eat your bread will set a trap for you, but you will not detect it. In that day, declares the Lord, will I not destroy the wise men of Edom, those who understand, those of understanding in the mountains of Esau? Your warriors, Taman, will be terrified, and everyone in Esau's mountains will be cut down in slaughter because of the violence against your brother Jacob. You will be covered with shame. You will be destroyed forever. On the day you stood aloof while strangers carried off his wealth, and foreigners entered the gates and cast lots for Jerusalem. You were like one of them. You should not gloat over your brother in the day of his misfortune, nor rejoice over the people of Judah in the day of their destruction, nor boast so much in the day of their trouble. You should not march through the gates of my people in the day of disaster, nor gloat over them in their calamity in the day of their disaster, nor seize their wealth in the day of their disaster. You should not wait at the crossroads to cut down their fugitives, nor hand over their survivors in the day of their troubles. The day of the Lord is near for all nations. As you have done, it will be done to you. Your deeds will return on your own head. Just as you drank on my holy hill, so all the nations will drink continually. They will drink and drink, and be as if they had never been. But on Mount Zion will be deliverance. It will be holy. And Jacob will possess his inheritance. Jacob will be a fire, and Joseph a flame. Esau will be stubble. And they will set him on fire and destroy him. There will be no survivors from Esau. The Lord has spoken. People from the Negev will occupy the mountains of Esau. People from the foothills will possess the land of the Philistines. They will occupy the fields of Ephraim and Samaria, and Benjamin will possess Gilead. This company of Israelite exiles who are in Canaan will possess the land as far as Zarephath. The exiles of Jerusalem who are in Sephard will possess the towns of the Negev. Deliverers will go from Mount Zion to govern the mountains of Esau, and the kingdom will be the Lord's. Alright, any questions?
What book are we doing next?
Okay, any questions about this? So, who are the Edomites?
They are a nation of people.
Yeah, but where did they come from? This is pretty neat when you think about it. So, remember back in January and the beginning of February when we read Genesis?
Nope.
You don't remember the beginning of the year?
I barely remember what I had for breakfast today, dude.
So we read Genesis, right?
Yeah.
And remember Isaac?
Sort of.
He was Abraham's
son. Oh, yeah.
He had the two sons?
Yep, I know.
They were twins?
Yep.
Jacob and...
Yep. Edom?
Esau?
Oh.
But Edom is the descendants of Esau.
I was close.
That's why he keeps talking about Esau through here.
I was close.
Right. And so what happened was when Babylon attacked Israel, Edom stood there and kind of laughed and then went in and stole stuff and kind of helped them instead of helping Israel. And so that's why God was mad at them. But they thought that they were, like, so untouchable because they lived in the mountains. They thought they were safe. And God's like, no. This whole
mountains this closer to the sky.
Yeah.
Meteors easier to hit there.
Okay, but I don't think that's what happened. I think Babylon took them out too.
Still.
Okay.
Meteor.
Damn it. No meteors. They don't have no meteors. But then if you read, the day of the Lord is near for all nations. So that's good news for us too, right? Because we're always looking forward to the day of the Lord. We're always looking forward to Jesus returning. Remember, the whole Bible is about Jesus, right? Okay, I don't see any other questions. So your second question was, what are we reading tomorrow?
I think I found it. Yeah.
I'm guessing at least four. So, all right. We'll see you tomorrow evening as we begin the book of John. Let's pray. Dear Lord Jesus, we thank you for all that you give us. We thank you for your word. We pray that we learn from it and that we are humble and we recognize you and your power in all things. We love and praise you, Lord Jesus, as we pray in the Lord Jesus Christ's name.